Hello guys, back here with another video, and today we're talking about raw versus equipped. So, what is raw lifting? Raw lifting is where you wear knee sleeves, or in some federations, knee wraps, or either nothing on your knees. You have no suits or no bench press shirts. You are allowed wrist wraps and belts, however. Equipped lifting is obviously where you use a squat suit, a deadlift suit, a bench press shirt, with all the other stuff mentioned. Equipped lifting is split into multiple categories. You've got the most popular, which is single ply, you've got multi ply, and you've got unlimited for benching, but for purposes today, we're going to be talking solely about single ply, and to be more specific, single ply to the IPF standard. And for raw, we're going to be talking about knee sleeve raw again to the IPF standard. So, which do I prefer? I'll straight away say I prefer lifting equipped, and here is why. There is a lot more variables we equipped. So, that basically means that when you're equipped, there's a lot more things that could go wrong, which also makes it a lot more fun. And there is a lot of things that could make you better than you've ever been before, which is very, very good. For example, the adjustment available through bench shirts, i.e. the collar, the twisting the sleeves inwards, all sorts of different things. And obviously you've got different bench shirts, you know, different brands, different stitching, different collars, all going to have a tremendous impact. And same with the squat suits and knee wrapping styles. Not so much with deadlift. There's a lot of debate about how much you actually get out of a suit for deadlifting. I know my dad gets about 30 kilos out of it, or I get about 3 kilos out of it. And a lot of people tend to be either end of the spectrum, where you get loads or you get nothing. And for the squat, I get about 50 kilos. And for the bench press, I get between 50 and 60 kilos. That's all with, again, the standard equipments for single ply. Raw lifting, however, there is less variables because you're always going to be in the same equipment, and unless your belt's feeling a bit tighter, you know, unless you're a bit heavier, you're not really going to get anything different out of your equipment. That's always going to feel the same. Same with the knee sleeves, if you're a bit heavier, they're going to feel a bit tighter, you may get more kilos there. Well, not really, and you don't get much out of sleeves at all compared to wraps. Completely different game. The best knee sleeve will be nowhere near. The best knee sleeve will not be as good as the worst wrap in the world. That's how good knee wraps are. So, what else makes me favour equipped lifting? Well, I find it to be a lot more. But I just find it to be more enjoyable. Like, the training is so much different if you fully commit to equipped lifting, because you'll be doing a lot more top end work, because you're always going to get it. Like, you'll be doing a lot of high end pin work, maybe blocks for bench, because you're always going to get it off that bottom, because that shirt's going to pop it up to about, you know, that shirt's always going to pop it to about there. It's just locking those last few inches out. So you're always going to be doing a lot of block work, potentially high pin presses. Squats, you're always going to be doing box squats, always. Deadlifts, block deadlifts, they're always king. Whereas raw, it's a lot more sticking point focused. So if you struggle getting it off the ground on deadlifts, you're going to be doing deficit deadlifts. If you're off the chest, it's going to be low pin presses, extra long pauses, and a lot of chest work. And for squats, obviously you're going to want pause squats. So it's just... I find the accessory work you do is a lot more fun for equipped lifting than it is raw, you know, stuff like that, the training in general. I also just like the feeling of the extreme compression, and above all else, I just like lifting the more weight. You know, it's just that simple. I'm in this sport to lift as much weight as possible, so I'm going to wear the equipment that allows me to lift as much weight as possible. So what's some pros about raw? We're not just hammering equipped on here. There is some good things about raw. It's a lot cheaper. And it's a lot easier to get into, as in it's a lot more accessible. and it's a lot less intimidating. It's how a lot of people will get into the sport. Like, most people's first impression of trying powerlifting will not be spending 20 minutes getting a suit on. It'll be spending 2 seconds getting some sleeves on and getting under a bar squatting or benching or deadlifting, you know what I mean? How I tend to find it, raw lifting brings all the lifters in, but equipped lifting keeps them in. You know, after a few years, when people start to get a little bit bored or something, potentially, they might turn to equipped lifting to see what it is, and hopefully that'll, you know, light a fire in them for powerlifting once again. It is just the cost of equipped lifting, though, that really, really harms it, with the main retailer in the UK, Pullum, costing £200 for a squat suit, £250 for a good bench shirt, and about £175 for the top deadlift suit. So it is an expensive game to get into, but it's all worth it. Even if you just ease yourself into it with some cheap knee wraps, like £20, they're very good ones as well. £20, yeah, Signature Golds. Oh yeah, THP's even cheaper. So knee wraps are a very good way to sort of like easier way into equipped lifting, is what I should say. But why do a lot of people hate equipped lifting? It's probably because they see it as cheating. You know, they want to see what people can do like for their raw strength, whereas that is it's like using a lifting aid. It's people may say, right, if you can use a bench shirt, why can't you just use a slingshot? Which is a completely, you know, fine statement. But there's a lot of skill that's involved with equipped lifting, a hell of a lot of skill. You know, you've got to learn your placements of your bench shirts, you know, lining them up perfectly, where the bar's got to land on the chest, how fast or how slow it can be, you know, getting down there. Your squats, you need to be able to know when you've hit that hole, when your entire legs have gone numb, you can't feel your toes, stuff like that. You just need to be able to build that feeling of where depth is. And same with the deadlift, you've got to be able to get down to that bar and fight through the pain of the suit while still being able to pop back up at an immense speed. So I hope I've given you a good comparison to raw versus equipped lifting. Like I said, I am in favour of equipped lifting just because I prefer more things about it. That's not to say I dislike raw, that's just saying I prefer slightly the things that you do equipped rather than raw. But like I said, that about does it for this week. Make sure you tune in next week. But until next time, keep lifting that big weight.